Hey, what is up guys? Gioco here, and today's video is going to be my deck profile about the True King Dinosaur deck with which I went 8-3 at the YCS Milan. So I bubbled YCS Milan, I just needed one more win in order to go to the top. That was it. I was so near, but I'm still so happy about how the deck performed. So let's get started and I hope you enjoy it. So for the big boys, I got to play two copies of Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. This card is so strong, attacks on everything, it breaks any kind of board. Then the one Kaiju decided to play this because of the Sky Striker matchups and it's so strong against Apollo Uza. Then the one Overtax, you don't need more than one, that's fine. And then the one Dino Wrestler Pankratops. This card is so amazing and you can bring it out with the help of DPT Pteranodon. Then for the starters, we got three copies of Oviraptor. This card is amazing. It starts any kind of combo. You can do everything with this, as you know. Then three copies of Miscellanosaurus. This card baits impermanence, baits Ash, baits Veiler, baits everything and allows you to start again and combo off. And then the one Giant Rex, because you need it. You can recycle it forever. Then I decided to play two Baby Cerasaurus and one Petite Pteranodon. I was still happy with this ratio, it was a nice choice in my opinion, because this allows you to go into your Pankratops, and you can go also to Oviraptor anyway, so it doesn't change so much. And then the one Juraka Yolo, which is useful both for going first, because you can go to Chula, and going second, because you can go into Chambara, that won me so many games. Then for the True King package, I got three copies of the Agnimazu and two copies of the Barastus. I think this ratio is fine, since playing two Barastus makes this always live and you can go into Calamities before the fifth summon, so you can bait also the Nibiru out. And that's it for the True King package. Then I played again four Dangers, the two Nesses and the two Mothmans. This card is fine because it allows you to draw and thin the deck in any scenario. It was useful also just discarding Nessie as one of in my hand to get to Mothman and then normal summon in this and go into an XYZ play. Then for spell cards, you got three copies of Draconic Diagram. This card is hands down the best card of the deck. So I decided to maximize this with the one Terraforming, the one Set Rotation, and the one Lost Word, because Lost Word is so strong again with the Sky Striker matchups, and there were lots of Sky Strikers there, so was one of the best choices. Then three Fossil Digs, of course, you wanna play three. This is basically Rota for the deck, nothing to say. Two copies of Call by the Grave, even if the deck is made for going first. I think you don't need the third one since you got Miscellanosaurus that can prevent also from the impermanence. That is a thing that Call by the Grave cannot do. And then two Cosmic Cyclones because of the meta. The one Pill is fine. If you go first, one is more than okay in my opinion. And the one Foolish Burial that acts as a standard and a starter as well. Then moving into the extra deck, I play the one Lagia, the one Dolka, of course, the one Dweller, then can win games alone. The one Dugarrez, this card is nonsense, so strong. And then for the rank 9s, we got the one Enter Blatnir and the one True King of All Calamities. This card is MVP of the event against Luna Orcust, against Orcust, against Heroes, against Palozoics as well. You just declare the right attribute and that's cool. Even against Salamangreats, but I didn't face a single one. Calamities is amazing. And then you can also tribute your opponent's monsters in the next turn. Then for the Synchros, the one Beast, useful against Sky Strikers, the one Chambara and the one Trishula. This is mandatory in my opinion. And then for the Lynx, we got one Reproducus. You gotta play it since it's a dinosaur and a combo piece as well. The one Phoenix, the one Mascarina. This card adds another layer of protection for you, and it's a generic Link 2, so you gotta play it in my opinion. The one Trisbane, because I hate back row decks, I use it against the Paleo matchup. The one Unicorn, and the one Avramax to end up for the extra deck. So basically you can do Avramax even with Mascarina, which is such a strong play because it's kind of impossible to remove this from the field, especially in grind game. Then for the side deck, I run two copies of Drone Lockbird. I was expecting a lot of Sky Strikers. This card was one of the best choices of the side deck. I should have played three probably. That's what I regret. I also used this against one Thunder Guard Dragon. It just activated the normal Thunder Dragon, activated this in chain, and that was it. Then two DD Crows. This card is amazing against a lot of decks, really a lot of decks. And Triple Lancia, which is, I think, the best hand trap of the format. No more Ash Blossom, as you can see. These are more relevant, in my opinion, so you want to play this. Then, for spell cards, I run in three copies of Mind Control. This card is amazing, is much more immediate than Evenly Matched. I didn't regret playing this. You can bait any kind of negation and or steal monsters from the opponent, so it's crazy. What do you want more? Then two copies of Twin Twisters because of the back row hate, and three copies of Red Reboot. This came up as well, allows you to OTK and protect yourself. Even from impermanences, Evenly Matched, and any kind of stuff. Also, there can be only one that can totally wreck this deck. So that's it for my list. Tokens in here, of course, that helped me out through the event. So the event was fine. I just lost to three different Sky Striker lists, but I won all the Orcus matchups, all the Lunatic Orcus matchups, and all the other matchups, hands down. You just go Calamities and win the game. So that's pretty much crazy in my opinion. So that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Shoutouts to my team, of course, the Omnia Players. Some of them borrow me the cards. Shoutouts to my YouTube channel. Follow me on YouTube and Yugioh Duel Calculator to calculate your life points. Shout out also to Ayub and Rocco that helped me making the list. And that's it for today. See you in the next one.